Now, the News 8 Storm Team Forecast with meteorologist Matt Ritter.
Compared to all that, we're getting away with something here, but we're not out of the woods yet. We're still going to have our own problems again the rest of the day today and more later on this evening into overnight tonight. Live Super Doppler 8 radar network showing these little bands of drizzle left over from overnight precipitation. And, of course, some of that is still freezing because temperatures are still below freezing. But things are really not going to be accumulating much additional during the afternoon. Just mainly cloudy and damp, patchy freezing drizzle, 28 to around 34 degrees. Treated surfaces will be getting a little better as we go through the afternoon because of the higher sun angle, even though it's cloudy. But then after this evening, sunset, some more light freezing rain starts arriving later on, 28 to around 32, and even more freezing rain later on tonight, and it could be moderate at times. Winds will start picking up 28 to around 32, and then temperatures will very slowly start to rise during the day tomorrow. 28 officially right now, winds are calm, very damp, the relative humidity at 90%. We're at 28 in Harrisburg and Lancaster and in York, 31 degrees in Chambersburg. We're kind of surrounded by some of the milder air now. It's definitely very mild aloft, which is why we're not dealing with pure snow anymore. We're melting whatever snowflakes are falling out of the clouds into liquid form. But as it hits the surface, which is still very, very cold, you get that sleet like we had early this morning, indicated there by the pink on the regional radars. But then you also have the freezing rain when the liquid makes it to the ground and then freezes on contact. So even though we're not getting much more additional precipitation this afternoon, remember, it's a long-lived situation here. The winter storm warnings continue all the way until 1 o'clock Wednesday afternoon. It's a plunge of Arctic air going well into Mexico. They've got freeze warnings all throughout southern Texas from this, and this pattern change has induced these two areas of low pressure, the first that affected us last night, and now this mammoth area of low pressure that's bringing all that severe winter weather to the Midwest. We're still going to be on the relatively warmer side of the system eventually, but we still have to deal with that cold air and the cold ground. So the next round of liquid that comes in later on tonight will be falling onto those cold surfaces, and the predictor's showing we've got more freezing rain on the way, certainly in time for midnight and the morning rush tomorrow. Then eventually some of the warmer air will start to mix in and change that freezing rain over to just plain rain. But then it's a very quick moving system. By this time tomorrow, we could already be seeing some clearing in some of the western counties. And then some colder air will come in again tomorrow. We may have to deal with some refreeze tomorrow night. But basically, other than that, we still have some more problems on the way. Cloudy and damp for the rest of this evening. The light freezing rain starts to return again as we head towards late evening and overnight tonight. 38 degrees, that'll be a late day high. That'll be probably tomorrow evening. And then it starts getting colder again. A brisk day on Thursday, high around 30 degrees. And then it looks like temperatures may actually get above freezing for a few days in a row. And we could be dealing with a mixture of snow and some rain as we head towards Saturday. We'll take one more look at that timetable later on.
All right, very good. Thanks, Matt.